only I could make my father understand.
Hey everybody, it's Christy. I'm back to do another video. I know it's been a really long time. Life is crazy. But I'm back and I'm very excited to be back. Today I'm doing something a little bit different. I'm going to be discussing my favorite Disney pieces that I have in my house. And you get to hear my neighbors. They're outside. It's great. So we're gonna get right into it. What I mean by my Disney favorites, I mean the items that my husband and I have purchased from the parks or the Shop Disney Parks app or the Disney store, anything like that, and that we display in our homes or collect. So let's get started. The first thing I want to show that I love so much is this awesome travel mug. It's Christmas! So we originally bought this at Disneyland in 2014 when we were there. Right in November, right when all of the Christmas festivities started. It was wonderful. We got hot chocolate in it, and I use it all the time for coffee, hot chocolate, anything. It's wonderful. On that same note of beverages is the cutest teapot in the entire world. Seriously, look at it. I'm obsessed. I haven't had the chance to use it yet since I got it as a gift from my husband for our anniversary this year. And it's been really, really warm and we don't have air conditioning as of yet, so I haven't had the chance to use it. So let's keep moving on. The next thing I'd like to show is my purse. I love my purse. It has Minnie and Mickey on the front and on the back. I also received that as a gift a couple of years ago from my grandma. It's very well used and very, very well loved. It gets a lot of comments. Again, it was a gift, so I'm not sure where she got that from. Next, I am going to delve into a couple of other Christmas type things. This is our Lumiere Christmas tree ornament. He is exactly like the giant replica of Lumiere. That is because he... Come on, son. Lights up! Yay! Beauty and the Beast isn't my favorite, and it's not my husband's favorite, so... But we still wanted it, so we decided it'd be best for us to get the smaller one. The next ornament I want to show you is... Ugh, I love it so much. This one is, I think, a really underrated movie. Oh, but I love it so much. It's Who Framed Roger Rabbit ornament. Look at him. He's on the front being goofy and adorable. And if you spin it, there's his lady Jessica looking glamorous. That was a Disney store find in Lumiere we found in the parks when we were in Disney World for my most recent birthday last December. So... Speaking of the parks, the next item is this Port Orleans Riverside Resort hat. I bought it for my husband for our most recent anniversary because as of right now, this is our very favorite resort. Each time we've gone to Disney World, which isn't very many times, we've stayed at this resort. We stayed at Port Orleans Riverside for our honeymoon. My husband surprised me with going to Port Orleans Riverside and it's gorgeous. It won my heart instantly. I went to New Orleans right after Hurricane Katrina, so Port Orleans Riverside and the French Quarter are really, really dear to my heart, and they bring back wonderful memories for me, so this is absolutely hands down my favorite resort as of right now, so I bought my husband this hat, and he loves it. The next item is a craft item that I did, since my husband and I are huge Disney fans, if you can't tell, I made... a replica of Eugene and Rapunzel's lanterns from Tangled. I am not an artist by any stretch of the means, and this was a really difficult project since painting on a circular shape is really hard, but I included our initials and our wedding date. And also, this lights up. It was a lot of fun to paint, and he loved it. So, that was really special, and we hang it somewhere where we can always see it. So, the next item you've seen in my videos before, and it's something that I'm a little bit obsessed with. I've had it for a couple years. It's my Dinglehopper. The Little Mermaid is my favorite movie, and Ariel is my absolute favorite princess. So it was kind of a no-brainer that I needed my very own Dinglehopper. It is an actual working brush. If you've seen any of my other videos, you've seen me use it on my hair. It's fantastic. I've had this for a couple of years, I think almost 4 years. I'm terrible with dates, but I've had this for quite a few years, and it's held up really, really well. But then again, I have a really sensitive head, so I'm very gentle with it. It's absolutely incredible. I've always wanted to be a mermaid, so. The next item is also Little Mermaid related, and that would be the Little Mermaid Sephora Ariel Lip Gloss Collection. I've had this also for a couple of years, but it's fabulous. I don't really like lip gloss all that much. However, this one, probably because it was Little Mermaid, really suckered me into it, and I love it. And it has all these different colors. This one is the brightest red, and like all of the packaging details have been rubbed off since I use it so much. And then that's a more pink, like a corally pink. This one is a divalicious purple. Oh, it is so fabulous. And then a more rosy pink. And of course, it has to go back in the packaging because it's Little Mermaid and I want to stare at it all the time. And then here's some product detail on the back. Okay, and here's the next item from that same collection, the Sephora Little Mermaid collection. It's nail polish! Guys! I also admit that I am kind of the worst with painting my nails. I really don't paint my fingernails since it chips off and all sorts of other things. However, this is pretty much always on my toes. I love it so much. Most of these are glitters, which is pretty much one of the main reasons why they are only on my toes is, I mean, look at that. That's a lot of glitter. So much glitter. This one in particular cracks me up with how much glitter is in there. But in the awesome way. I love it. So, yeah, that's that. I love it so much. It tends to chip off a little bit easily. However, I don't care. It's all about that Little Mermaid. And then there's the back. Nothing too exciting on there. But it's something that I love, something I use, something that makes me feel like my mermaidy self. And last but not least, it's Flounder. Seriously, the obsession with Little Mermaid is so real. I love Flounder so much. My husband found him for me in the kids' bedding section of Target. My husband knows how much I absolutely love Little Mermaid, and he is very encouraging with this rather unhealthy obsession. It was more of a, I'm an adult. I'm in graduate school. I don't need a cuddly little thing to snuggle with at night. My husband just looked at me and then put it in the cart, which means, yeah, you do. And suffice it to say, he's absolutely right. I love him. He's so great as a pillow or a cuddle buddy. And just makes my mermaid dreams real with my Dinglehopper and Flounder. Anyway, that's it. I hope that you enjoyed this rather eclectic, silly, different kind of video from me. I would love to hear what your Disney favorites are, such as your favorite movie or favorite item you picked up from the parks. Also, I can't recommend the Disney Shop Parks app enough. I'm obsessed with it. I've said that a couple other times about other things in this video, but really and truly, the Disney Shop Parks app is incredible! So kudos to you, Disney. I look at it all the time. I love seeing the new arrivals. And then I realize, oh, I have to stop or else I'm gonna buy everything. So I think it's such a fabulous tool to have for those of us who don't live as close to Disneyland or Disney World as we want to. So it's a great way to add some Disney magic to your home wherever you may live. I hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you next time. Goodbye.